You are all set.
All right. Morning, everyone. So I'm Casey Raymond. I'm in chemistry, and Jeff Schneider with me to talk about how we use release conditions and special access in Brightspace. And so we want to go over a few of the generalities between release conditions and special access and some reasons we use them and so forth. And then from a class last fall, I'll show you kind of how that works. We'll kind of walk through that. So jumping right in, release conditions are based on other elements or items within the course. Could be a student has actually looked at certain content. It could be they've submitted an assignment or a quiz. It could be they've scored some minimum score. It could be they belong to a particular section or group. Right? There's a huge list of potential release conditions. What we've found, and we could be wrong, but what we have realized is that dates of access are not adjustable with release conditions. If you set, you can set dates of access when it starts, when it ends, but those dates of access will be the same for that entire population of students that meet whatever release conditions you put in. All right. And maybe you want that, maybe you don't. For us, we didn't want that. Special access allows you to control when students can actually view content, quizzes, assignments, and you can control the dates, the due dates, the appearance dates across sections and groups. You can use this to extend deadlines. If you have a student that says, you know, they have a really good reason for needing an extra day or two to complete an assignment, you can extend the deadline for that student with special access. This is different from providing extra time as an accommodation. There's actually a really easy way to do extended time for an accommodation that works completely across everything you have in the course. So you basically set it one place and it works across the board. But we've all had the cases where a student, you know, overslept or they had some kind of situation arise and you're like, yeah, fine. You can have another day to submit the assignment. This is a way to give that student permission to another day to do it. All right. Anything I missed on these two, Jeff?
I don't think so. I think the important thing is getting used to how the dates work. That's the big part.
And so how do we and why do we use these? And we did similar things in Blackboard, so we had to learn how to do it in Brightspace last fall. Is Jeff and I coordinate the general chemistry labs, and we merge all of the sections of the course into one offering. And sometimes that's 15 plus lab sections, sometimes it's 20 lab sections that are all in one offering. And so then we can adjust or set due dates and access dates based on what section they're in, or more often, what day of the week they meet. So instead of having every single lab report due Sunday night, it's due the night before their class meets. Because if a student does the lab on Thursday and it's due Sunday night, that's a whole lot less time for them to work on it than the student that does it on Monday and has a full week to do it. And so we create groups for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and use special access so that whatever day of the week they meet, they get a full 7 days to do the assignment or the quiz. And that's how and why we use special access and release conditions. going to hop over to Brightspace. You need to adjust the release conditions or special access within the assignment or quiz. So you can pull down and get your list of assignments or your list of quizzes, and then you can edit the quiz or edit the assignment. I'm going to go to an assignment where I've already opened it to edit. And so this view hopefully looks familiar. You've got availability and conditions. We have submission completion information, the evaluation and feedback. Where we want to work is availability, dates, and conditions. And you can see already that we have 246 users that have special access. And if you know you had 250 students that should have it, this is a flag that, why are students missing? I'm going to open the release condition issue. So here's where we could add the start date, the end date. But if I open release condition and I say I want to create new, you can pick the condition type from this list, which is very large. So you can see if they've done something with an assignment, if they've satisfied a checklist, if they're in a particular group or section, if they've reached competency, if they've actually looked at some content you've established or done discussions. Right? So these are all of the different items that you can base a release condition upon. But when you do that and you pick one of these, and it becomes up, okay, what group? I'll say the Monday group, and I say create. Now only people in the Monday group see this information, and only these dates apply if I put them in. Okay. Which is not really what we want to do. If I added the Tuesday group, the same dates apply. And so that's where we use special access. And so when I open this, I didn't want to show that way with students. When I open that, you get your listing and your special access. I thought the students wouldn't be there.
I don't know that it matters if we see names.
We can edit.
Yeah, we'll see.
We can edit it out.
Yeah. So that's where the managed special access is in assignments. Same in the release conditions. I'm going to look at the quiz. This is the quiz view that everybody saw in the fall, that everybody's still seeing, but is likely to change before the semester begins Monday. If you haven't heard that information, the only thing that's going to change is the way it looks. All of the things are still going to be here, but instead of it being these tabs across the top of the screen like this, it's going to look just like the assignment situation where it's a pull down along the right side. Right? And so we've got our quiz here. There's questions and the standard things we might put in a quiz. You do the adjustments in restrictions, or there'll be a tab for release conditions. And so this doesn't have a due date or availability listed here across the quiz for everybody, because we want it to be released based on when their class meets. And so we can go down here and say, add users to special access. Right. We get a big long list. And what I want to highlight is when you get to your list of users, if it's one student, you can search for their name. Right? Or you can look at the big list and find them in the list to check them off. If you want to base it on groups that you created, you pull the little down arrow and say groups. What's confusing or annoying, or just you got to get used to it, is you have to click apply before you can actually see the groups. And then if you only want to see the people in the Thursday group, you have to pick the Thursday group and click apply again. Do that before you go and start setting all the dates up here. Right. So then once you've got your group, you've got who you want to identify, you can checkbox who they are, right? Set whatever due dates and availability and access they should have. And then you click add special access and boom, there you go. They have special access. All right. And so it's thinking, what I want to do, I'm just going to go over and start a new quiz to show a little cleaner something. Quiz has to have a name. Notice in my special access, there's two types. I'll allow users with special access to this quiz. I'll allow only users with special access to this quiz. If you're just giving folks extended time, you probably want to use the first one. If you want to really restrict that only students that have access can see it, so only the Monday kids can see it when you set the dates, only the Tuesday kids can see it when you set the dates and so forth, you do that here. Allow users with special access to see it. Right. So there's a couple differences. I actually almost all the time just use this one. And you can use the bottom one for giving extended time as well. All right. And so that's how we use more so the special access to control when students get to see quizzes, assignments, but you can apply all these same principles to any content in the course. And I think the really, as Jeff said, the key thing to keep in mind is special access allows you to control when people see things. The release conditions is if they've done certain things, if they've achieved certain accomplishments, then they can move on to the next content. Anything to add, Jeff? Questions from?
I was gonna say, and you would think that the release conditions would say, okay, if it is this date, release it. Unfortunately, it's not. So, and that's why we use the special access. So.
So you have to set both of these up when you set up the assignment?
You don't have to set both up when you set the assignment, but it's helpful if you want to use them to do it from the start. The one thing is if you create the assignment and it's visible to the students without any conditions, then everybody can see it.
Okay.
If you want, from the point that you want students to be able to view things, you want certain criteria to be met, whether it's release conditions or the special access, you could create it in advance and make it hidden so students can't see it until you are able to go in and do these things. So if you've already got some assignments made or you already have some content or items ready to go and you realize you want to control when or how or who gets to see things, you could start with them all hidden.
Okay.
All right.
Then go back and fix, set whatever you want and then make them visible and then only certain people can see them at certain times.
Right. And if you start a new assignment or a new quiz or whatever, I believe the default is that it's already hidden.
Okay.
So if you do a new one, it's automatically hidden from users. And so that's always something to remember too, because if you don't know that and you make a quiz and you're like, oh, why can't anybody see it? Well, because you forgot to uncheck either the box here or, once it's in your Brightspace, to move the little flag over or whatever. So once you deploy it.
And when you go and look at your list of quizzes or assignments or whatever, you'll probably see a little eye with a slash through it. And that's your clue. Oh, it's hidden. They can't see it. Right. And so that's also a way to pretty quickly look and see, wait, can they, did I forget to unlock it or not? Anytime that you see this key, that's a indication that special access is required.
Okay. And it's the slanted key?
Correct.
Yeah.
The thing that's vertical, it's actually a ribbon.
Oh.
Is in the grade book.
Okay.
It looks like a key, but it's vertical.
Yeah.
Yep.
And just so you, because we're here and it's another symbol, this little almost looks like a turtle at an angle.
Okay.
The arrow going around a dot. That's telling you that you have exempted that grade for some student or more.
Okay.
In that quiz or assignment. That for some reason you exempted them from having to do that.
Okay.
So it's another nice little clue that might show up occasionally.
The other question I have is, I'm using checklists this semester, and I'm wondering, like, can you set up release conditions in conjunction with checklists? Or does it have to be with, like, a specific, like, assignment or a quiz?
I would guess you can, because I know you can set conditions for content, but I've never done a checklist. Jeff, okay. Have you?
Never.
Okay.
So let's see.
So there's restrictions.
So right here is a restrictions tab. And it looks like it just does release conditions. So not the special access. So it's going to be based on the fact that they've done something before they can do the checklist.
Okay. Because I kind of want to, if I can, I want to set it up so that like some students, if they're ready to go on to the next thing, that I don't hold them back from it. But then I don't want necessarily everything to be visible to all students, because some students might get overwhelmed. So
I think, I mean, if it's, so how are you going to decide if they're ready to move on?
Well, because I have like a lot of reading in there, there's some students that are able to handle like managing what we're talking about now and then what we're going to be talking about, because they just, you know, they can do that. And other students need to spend the actual time we're spending on that one thing right then and not move any further. So like there's some readings that I have, and I have my checklist set up by week. And so, and with tasks in each of those weeks. So I'm just wondering if there's a way I could set it up where some students who are ready to move forward, or kind of like, you know, well, we're hanging around in this part and I'm kind of a little bored, I want to read something else, you know, can move on. And the other students can just stay with where we're at. I don't know if I explained that right, but
nope, I got it. It works just fine. So I'm curious how you do a competency. So I think it's a matter of either making a quiz or go back to my checklist that I just created. I think there's some ways to do it, Linda. It's a matter of deciding what's going to be easiest.
Yeah.
So if I'm editing this checklist, I've got restrictions. I can create restrictions based on all the different things for release conditions. And so you could potentially have a competency. I don't know anything about those or how they work. But okay. If it's a way to set that up, or if there's a simple quiz you can do, even if it's one that you self-grade, You know, it's a written response quiz where they have to type in that, yep, they're ready to go on. They learn these things from the readings. And so once they've gotten a certain score on that quiz, you pick the quiz, you can set what the criteria is. So once they score this much on the quiz, then the checklist would be released.
Okay.
So that might be a way for you to help use release conditions going down the pathway. So, you know, it's really setting up. And you could have, to be honest, if it's a, if you want them to complete, you know, they've done these readings and you want them to confirm some things on a checklist, you could actually set it up so that they complete the check. Your release condition for the new content is that they've completed the checklist.
Okay.
So for what you're talking about, release conditions are probably the best way to go. Because you want students to demonstrate something before they move on. It's just a matter of how you're going to measure that demonstration.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, and it looked like you could do checklist items there as well, not just the whole checklist.
Not just the whole list, so. So, you know, quick summary, that's how we use these tools and what we've learned so far. It does seem there's a huge amount of things that you can actually do or accomplish with them, and we're all learning kind of down the way, but we felt it was worthwhile to share how we've been using special access because, you know, everybody's still learning it. So thank you, everyone. And
yep.
Thank you.
Yep, thank you.
See you later.
You.